lot more coming up. If you are just joining us, a special guest host today is John Edward.
Yeah!
Yeah! Rounding up the panel, we have Dicko back for another day. Yeah! And Angela Coutures as well. So
thank you very much.
And beautiful Jess.
Yeah! Oh, thank you!
All right, let's get into our hot topics for this morning. And Sunrise has been accused of victim shaming over an insensitive Facebook post. It blamed 500 Adelaide women after nude photos of them were stolen and posted on a US website. The post read, "What's it going to take for women to get the message about taking and sending nude photos?" The show has apologised, but not before a social media frenzy that spawned the hashtag For Shame Sunrise. What do you make of this, Dicko?
I honestly don't know what I think about this. I'm worried about having all of my money electronically held because I don't trust, you know, the online world. And I certainly wouldn't encourage my daughters to, you know, take nude photos and put them somewhere in the cloud just because I don't trust it. I don't know if the word is online blaming. Maybe there's a softer way of looking at it, online cautioning. Because, you know, everyone does have a responsibility for what they do with their own image. And surely, you know, that is an act of illegality to steal those and upload them. But they are there in the first place and it's not as safe an environment as you would imagine.
Can I put something to you? Yeah. What if you had photos of your daughters as babies, naked in the bath, on your computer?
We do.
Yep. Some idiots hacked into your cloud, took those naked photos and put them on a pedophile website.
Yeah, well, of course, that is, you know, that's an act of illegality. As I said, look, I don't know. I certainly wouldn't be making young women feel bad about themselves, but at the same time, I don't know, it's just such an unknown new world, isn't it, that we're getting into?
Well, as you say, it is a new world, but I think the reality is that's how young people kind of get to know each other, so to speak, that they might be taking nude pictures of themselves to share with their partner or their boyfriend. Not that you think, oh, that's a smart idea, but that's sort of what they do. And so I think something that you do either in a moment of passion or you think this is what you're meant to do, to have then that used against you and used in a very different environment to what you ever intended is very wrong. And I think we have to be careful about blaming young women for those images because for them, that's their image, that's them being powerful and sexy and that's how they share it.
I get that, but there's a risk, isn't there?
There absolutely is a risk. And as we've discussed on this show before, I think that you have to be really mindful of your privacy settings. If you're going to upload photos to what you think is your personal website or rather your personal, you know, Facebook page or Instagram, you have to be really mindful of what the privacy settings are so that they're not shared far and wide.
But even apart from that, though, there's this awful thing which I only recently discovered, revenge porn. So you might be incredibly private about your settings and all of that, but, and you send it to someone who you intend is the only person who's going to see it, and then they turn bitter and twisted and that's share awful. It with everyone. That, you know, you cannot control that.
Shouldn't we be opening up the conversation to talk with our sons, to say to them, you know, it's not cool to take a photo of someone that you have shared a closeness with and to humiliate them like that. That's not a nice thing to do. Like, shouldn't we not be kind of changing the conversation a little bit? I don't know.
I think so. I think you're spot on.
Yep.
Definitely.
Point. You've got teenage
I do.
Kids.
I have a, you know, I have a 13-year-old and I have an 8-year-old, but I kind of think it goes back to, like, I think my 7th grade teacher said, Mrs. Gordon, she said, if you write it down, expect it to be on the front page of the paper. So it was like being accountable for your actions, whether it's words, photos, whatever. I think you have to kind of think about it. And I think it's scary. The whole, I agree with you with the online stuff. It's like, it's not safe.
Let's look at some feedback that's coming in on this topic. We have a couple. This from Sharon. I don't disagree, but I do think the main focus needs to be on the people who posted the pics on that website. Yeah. They are the ones who did the wrong thing. And then there's this from Catherine. Thinking we have the right to do anything we want without consequences is just plain stupid. When will people learn? The old saying, you make your bed, you lay in it, is very apt. And finally, this from Shaylee. It's horrid. You should be able to take what you want and send to those you trust and not have them some vile human steal them. When did stealing become okay, but taking private photos not?
Good point.
It's fraught with danger, though, isn't it?